A shocking soundbite is going viral after CNN decided to talk about the Russia dossier that President Donald Trump has most recently called a pile of garbage. Unfortunately for the liberal network, things quickly took a turn for the worst just a few moments into the segment, and viewers were left shocked by what a guest let slip on live television. You'd have to be an idiot to think that the conspiracy theories surrounding the idea of Trump and Russian collusion have any legitimacy. After a long and costly investigation, there's virtually no evidence to support the claims whatsoever. Even worse yet, the allegations simply came about all because a desperate Hillary Clinton didn't want to take the blame for losing the election. Even the Trump-Russia dossier released by BuzzFeed has been exposed to be nothing more than fake news that was bought and paid for, yet again, by the previously mentioned pathetic two-time presidential loser. Repeatedly, the left still revisits the document that has been debunked countless times. At this point, even Trump has had enough and has taken to Twitter to call it a pile of garbage. Currently, there are investigations into the firm that was hired to create the dossier, and even worse for crooked Hillary, this has allowed authorities to look elsewhere into her criminal past as well. Shockingly, it seems that not even all that is clear enough to keep liberals away, as they still don't mind handling the steaming pile of crap. Proving that most recently, CNN has taken advantage of Trump's recent comments pertaining to the dossier as an excuse to once again talk about the big nothing burger. As it turns out, it seems that the fake news networks are still up to the same old tricks. Even worse yet, it looks like they're now actively trying to brainwash the American people into thinking that the Trump-Russia dossier wasn't brought about by dirty Democrats. In fact, viewers would be left stunned just a few moments into the segment after what CNN Justice correspondent Evan Perez let slip on live television. According to the Daily Caller, Perez told his network's viewers on Tuesday that anti-Trump Republicans first funded the infamous Trump-Russia dossier, much of which remains unverified. In all, he told viewers that the fact is that the dossier was compiled as part of opposition research, first paid for by Republicans who were opposed to Donald Trump and then later on by Democrats and the Clinton camp, people associated with the Clinton campaign who wanted to try to bring him down.
Investigation was based on the intelligence dossier, but it's not that simple, is it?
Right. It really is not that simple, Brianna. Look, the fact is that the dossier was compiled as part of opposition research, first paid for by Republicans who were opposed to Donald Trump, and then later on by Democrats and the Clinton camp, people associated with the Clinton campaign who wanted to try to bring him down. It was opposition research, and it was compiled by a former British intelligence officer. But I think the underlying thesis of the dossier is this, is that Russia was trying to use connections with the Donald Trump campaign, people inside the Trump campaign and associated with the Trump campaign, to try to use that to have some influence. And that, as you know, is something that the intelligence community was very much concerned about. They took it very seriously, and it has formed the basis for this investigation. That is the basis for this investigation, which is now being handled by Robert Mueller, special counsel. We have to remind people, too, that there's four people who have been charged as a result.
Too bad for Evan Perez. There was just one problem. It was a flat-out lie. The fact that he cited that anti-Trump Republicans originally funded the dossier has been ruled false by fact-checkers. The truth is actually not even remotely close to what CNN is reporting. As the Daily Caller further explains, Republican donor Paul Singer initially hired Fusion GPS through the Washington Free Beacon to conduct opposition research on Trump and other candidates during the 2016 Republican primary, but that research was unrelated to the dossier. Shockingly, this isn't the first time that CNN has lied to viewers about the dossier's origins. In fact, this would be the third time that the network intentionally told its audience that Republicans originally funded the dossier. In other words, CNN is spreading more fake news. After hearing all the complaints they dish out every time Trump calls them fake news, you'd think they would be more careful when it comes to what they broadcast to their viewers. Until they start doing honest reporting, they're just going to have to deal with ratings that are rightfully in the toilet. The American people aren't stupid, so it'd be smart for CNN to stop treating us like we are.
Lawyers for President Trump keep saying they expect the Russia probe to wind up soon, at least the parts involving the president. But Robert Mueller may have other ideas, with a new report suggesting the special counsel may be widening his probe by now going after the Trump campaign's digital team. That, as questions continue to mount about perceived bias at the Justice Department and the FBI, clouding these various investigations so much that one Republican lawmaker suggested this week there should be a purge of those law enforcement agencies.
I would like to see the directors of those agencies purge it and say, look, we've got a lot of great agents, a lot of great lawyers here. Those are the people that I want the American people to see and know the good work's being done, not these people who are kind of the deep state.
Now, in response, Ohio Democratic Congressman Tim Ryan issued a statement saying Republican calls to undermine these most basic pillars of our democracy are not normal. They aren't just politics. They are downright un-American. Being able to independently investigate our own government free from political influence is what makes our nation great, and it's what sets us apart from the rest of the world. For more, let's bring in Matt Gaetz. He's a Republican congressman from Florida. Good to see you. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year almost, sir.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to you as well, Ed.
Congressman, do we need to see a purge at the FBI?
Well, let me start by saying that Tim Ryan doesn't have the right to shine Francis Rooney's shoes. Ambassador Rooney has worked overseas on behalf of the United States of America and knows full well the good work that far too many, or a great deal of folks are doing at the FBI and Department of Justice. The problem is in the swamp of Washington, D.C., the biggest alligator is a politicized FBI and Department of Justice. And that's why we're fighting hard to make sure that we've got a fair and equal opportunity for all sides to be heard and that you don't have this pro-Hillary Clinton bias, anti-Donald Trump bias, continue to infect our institutions and our systems that all Americans should be able to rely on.
I hear you defending Congressman Rooney, but do you agree with him? You're upset about the FBI and what's going on, but should there be a purge?
Well, the purge is happening. We just saw Andrew McCabe announce his retirement recently. You saw Bruce Orr, who was at the Department of Justice, demoted. And you saw Peter Strzok, the person who sent these horrible anti-Trump text messages, the same Peter Strzok who was very involved in the exoneration statement for Hillary Clinton and then got drafted into the Mueller probe. He's also been demoted and reassigned. And so time and again, you see the senior leadership at these agencies exposed for their bias. And that shouldn't in any way impair the good work that folks on the ground are doing each and every day to protect the country.
Congressman, that's your view of the FBI. You just mentioned Robert Mueller. I did as well a moment ago. Yahoo News has a new report out. Here's what they say about the Mueller probe. Quote, in just the last few weeks, his prosecutors have begun questioning Republican National Committee staffers about the party digital operation that worked with the Trump campaign to target voters in key swing states. They're seeking to determine if the joint effort was related to the activities of Russian trolls and bots aimed at influencing the American electorate, according to two sources. So, bottom line, what does that tell you about the Mueller probe? Are they going after Jared Kushner, for example, the president's son-in-law, who helped run that digital operation?
Well, here's what we know. The DNC and Hillary Clinton were paying people to go and pay Russians to tell lies about the president. And I guess the best evidence of collusion against Republicans is that Republicans and Russia were all on the same internet at the same time. It's ludicrous. Why are we not investigating the real crimes of the real criminals? Why aren't we investigating why the DNC's activities with the Fusion GPS company that was employing Bruce Orr's wife, Nellie Orr? That's the real collusion, and it's just outrageous to see this biased Mueller probe continue. I mean, if Bob Mueller were any more biased, we'd have to give him credentials for the mainstream media.
So are you calling for Robert Mueller to be fired when you say he's biased?
Yeah. Absolutely. I've been calling for Mueller to be fired for months now, and over 20 members of the House Judiciary Committee have been calling for a second special counsel to investigate the Clinton Foundation and Hillary Clinton, because there very well may be circumstances where the consequence of those bribes may be undermining American security moving forward. That's why we've got to get to the bottom of it, and we've got to end
I've just got 30 seconds
in the Trump presidency.
Let me unpack that, though. There have been some Republicans even saying if what happens is what you want, and the president fires Robert Mueller, we're going to have a constitutional crisis. You're okay with that?
No, the attorney general should fire him. No, the president shouldn't have to fire him.
The attorney general accused himself. He's not
involved. Yeah, but that's the problem. We've got an attorney general who's a spectator rather than the leader of the Department of Justice, and that undermines our democracy. There's no legal requirement for him to have recused himself in this matter. He needs to step up, be the attorney general, fire Mueller, and appoint a second special counsel to evaluate the Clinton Foundation.
Strong words from the congressman. I suspect you might be fired up in part because of the Independence Bowl. I'm contractually obligated by Shannon Bream, my colleague, who has Florida State ties, as do you. Florida State 42, Southern Miss 13. Looks like you had a big bowl victory. Congratulations.
Absolutely. Go Noles, and I know Shannon was watching and cheering for him.
She was. She'll be back next week. Happy New Year, sir.